وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول.
A question I asked. I watch a lot of speakers' corner videos in Hyde Park and notice many Muslims quoting from the Bible and the Torah. However, I have never seen you doing this. Is there a reason why you don't do this? And if you deem it to be impermissible, then why do we find Ibn Taymiyyah doing this?
Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, lahu alhamdul hasan, wa thana'u al-jameel, wa shahadu an la ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika lah. Yaqulu al-haqqa wa huwa yahdi al-sabeel, wa shahadu anna Muhammadan abduhu wa rasooluh. Sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa ashabihi, wa attabi'ina lahum bi ihsanin ila yawmi al-deen amma ba'd. I want to respond by saying that it is not permissible qira'atul kutub, reciting a book that has inside it al-haq wal-batil, the truth and the falsehood. It is not permissible to read a book like that. A person should have trust in the two main sources of al-Islam, al-kitab wa-sunnah. You should trust the book of Allah and the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The truth is not outside the Qur'an and the sunnah. The truth is restricted to the Qur'an and the sunnah. ولذلك the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he prohibited Umar radiallahu anhu when he saw him reading one of the books of the people of the scripture. The Prophet became excessively angry. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, أَمُتَهَوِّكُونَ فِيهَا يَبْنَ الْخَطَّابِ. Are you in a state of confusion, Ibn al-Khattab? Yani Umar, are you in a state of confusion? The Prophet said, وَالَّذِي نَفْسِي بِيَدِهِ. I swear by the Lord in which my soul is in his hand. لَقَدْ جِئْتُكُمْ بِهَا بَيْضَاءَ نَقِيَّةً. I have come to you guys with a religion that is pure and it's clean. And then the Messenger swore by Allah again. He said, وَالَّذِي نَفْسِي بِيَدِهِ. I swear by the Lord, my soul is in his hand. لَوْ أَنَّ مُوسَى كَانَ حَيَّا مَا وَسِعَهُ إِلَّا أَن يَتَّبِعَنِي. The Prophet said, if Musa was alive and he was in the world today, there would be no other path written for him. There would be no other path sanctioned for him except to follow me, يعني نبي الله محمد. Ahmad narrated that in his Musnad. So this hadith clearly shows us that it's not permissible for a person to read the books of the people of the scripture. The person can read it if he's gained knowledge of the Qur'an and the Sunnah and he's grounded with the Qur'an and the Sunnah. The person can read it. Shaykh al-Islam Taymiyyah, he read the books of the philosophers because he was grounded in his own knowledge and his own religion. Shaykh al-Islam Ibn Taymiyyah read the books of the Rafida, al-Shia, and he grounded himself in it. And so he wrote works in refuting it, like his kitab, Minhaj al-Sunnah al-Nabawiyyah fi naqd kalam al-Shia al-Qadariyyah, where he refuted the Shia, the Qadariyyah. Shaykh al-Islam Taymiyyah, he knew what was for him, and then he studied what was out there said about Islam. He defended the religion. So first of all, learn your religion. Learn the Qur'an. Learn the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Shaykh al-Islam Taymiyyah, he read the scriptures of the people of the books, and he refuted them. He wrote a kitab called Al-Jawab al-Sahih liman baddala deen al-Masih, where he responded to the Christians. But then, but that came about for Shaykh al-Islam Ibn Taymiyyah after he studied the Qur'an and the Sunnah and he studied the statements of the early scholars of al-Islam. He was able to go and study their works. If you're like him or you have knowledge of your religion and you're grounded, then there's no problem. But if not, don't waste your time reading their works. Busy yourself in studying the Qur'an and the Sunnah of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Anything which I have said that was wrong or incorrect is from me, a shaytan, and Allah and His Messenger are both free from it. Subhanaka Allahumma bihamdi, ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayh.
If you have any questions you'd like to see answered as part of this series, then you can email us at questions@amau.org.